Welcome back to another Elishop video. Today we're tackling a very important question. Can you measure mains with an oscilloscope? The answer is yes, but only if you do it safely. And in this video, I'll show you exactly how. Let's start with what not to do. Many people think they can use a standard passive probe, like the Sigland one, to measure main voltage. But that's dangerous, and here's why. You see, the alligator clip is connected directly to the earth ground of our electrical system through the BNC connector. And by connecting the earth ground wire directly to the L or N phase of our electrical system, short circuit the mains. In the best case, we trip our circuit breaker, but we could potentially destroy something inside our scope due to the high current flow, or even worse, causing electrical shock or serious injury. So remember, never connect a passive probe directly to the mains. Keep in mind that even when using devices like power supplies, you can encounter risky scenarios. For example, the negative output of some power supplies is internally connected to earth ground. That means your circuit, which might seem isolated, can become earth referenced the moment you connect it to the power supply. This can lead to short circuits. To be safe, always use a multimeter to check whether your circuit's ground is connected to mains earth before making any measurements with your passive probe. So how can we measure mains connected circuits with an oscilloscope? Some people try to measure mains by floating their oscilloscope. That means disconnecting the scope's ground lead by using, for example, a power bank, so the whole oscilloscope floats electrically and isn't connected to earth ground. So in this schematic, the ground is cut off. This can work in theory, because it prevents the scope ground from creating a short circuit to earth ground. But it's still very dangerous, because when the oscilloscope is floating like this, its metal chassis and connectors can become live at high voltage. If you accidentally touch the scope's metal part or case, you could get a serious electrical shock. So while floating your oscilloscope can let you take certain measurements, it's not considered safe. To perform safe measurements on a mains connected circuit, you need a differential probe like the Micsig DP700. This is a special probe, which can measure voltages without a ground connection. A differential probe measures the difference between two voltage potentials, without affecting the oscilloscope ground with the circuit you're measuring. This avoids the grounding problem, making it much safer for high voltage measurements like mains or three-phase systems. The Micsig DP700 is part of the Micsig DP series, a range of high voltage differential probes available from 700 volt peak up to 7000 volt peak, with bandwidths ranging from 100 MHz to 500 MHz. It's an affordable choice that has proven itself over the past 5 years. The probe uses safety banana connectors, which are ideal because they allow secure, insulated connections, and they work with standard test leads or alligator clips. Differential probes aren't perfect. When measuring low voltage signals, for example, a 1 volt peak-to-peak sine wave, you often notice more noise compared to a regular passive probe. At 20 volt peak-to-peak, the noise is already much less noticeable. And at 230 volts, it's barely visible at all. But for high voltage work, this is a trade-off worth making for safety. Let's take a closer look at how to measure mains in practice. Now, let's go through the setup. Connect the DP700 to your oscilloscope. For mains voltage, we always set it to 200 times, which means 700 volts peak. This gives us enough room for our measurement. We use an AC line splitter, so you can safely connect to mains, while not exposing line voltage on metal parts. A line splitter separates the conductors inside the cable, letting you connect measurement tools like clamp meters or differential probes without cutting cords or exposing wiring. It's a must-have when working safely around mains. Here you can see that with a differential probe you can measure mains with your oscilloscope. You'll notice that the voltage measurement is incorrect. Set the probe attenuation on the scope to 200 times to match the attenuation of the probe. This way the voltage reading on the display will match the true voltage. Important to keep in mind is that mains voltage in Europe is 230 volts, root mean square. But the actual waveform swings much higher. The peak voltage is about 325 volts, phase to neutral. So peak to peak, you're looking at around 650 volts. Your probe and oscilloscope must be able to handle that safely. The Micsig DP700 can handle 700 volts peak, so it can handle 325 volts easily. So, can you measure mains or three-phase voltages with an oscilloscope? Yes, but only with the right probe and proper safety measures. A differential probe like the Micsig DP700 is the safest and most reliable way to do it. And remember, never just put a passive probe in your outlet. Always use the right tool for the job. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and check out our knowledge base to learn more about testing and measuring. Thanks for watching.